Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, so now we are going to start with the first problem on nth derivative of transcendental function. So here I have one transcendental function for you, and for which we are going to find out the nth derivative by using the rules of successive differentiation. So friends, here if you see, then we have function y as e to the power ax cos square x sin x, and we have to find out the nth derivative, which is given as yn. Now the question is how to find out the nth derivative of this transcendental function. So guys, before proceeding ahead, let me show you the formula which is matching with this given function. So here in this function, we have exponential term, that is e to the power x, and the trigonometric term, that is cos square x and sin x. Now guys, we have a formula which exactly matches with this form. So here on the screen you can see that we have a formula called as when we have y as e to the power ax sin bx plus c, the nth derivative is given by r to the power n e to the power ax sin of bx plus c plus n phi. The value of r is under root a square plus b square, and value of phi is tan inverse b by a. So guys, I am sure that you have revised my previous video, because in my previous videos I have taken this formula and I have shown you how this formula has been derived. So guys, I am going to use this formula. Now if I want to use this formula, then in this formula I have exponential term as e to the power ax and the trigonometric term as sine. Now guys, similarly we have formula number 8 where we have e to the power ax into cos. So the only difference is in the answer here we'll get cos. So it means if I want to apply this formula, then I should have only one term as exponential and one term as trigonometric. But if you observe here I have e to the power ax, but I have cos square with sin x. So it means I can't apply that formula as it is. So to apply that formula over here, what I'll do is I'll first convert this given function in that form. So for that guys, I'm going to use the formula of defactorization. So let's start with that. So here what I'll say is y is e to the power ax into cos square x. Here I'll write it as cos x into cos x. So cos x into sin x. Now guys, for this cos x into sin x, I can apply the defactorization formula. So here we will get y as e to the power ax. This cos x will remain as it is. And this is the formula of 2 cos a into sin b. Now guys, again I am telling you, if you have not revised the trigonometric formula, then go back, watch my videos and do the trigonometric formulas, because then only you will be able to solve this question in the exam. So for time being, I will tell you the answer. So answer for cos x into sin x is half in bracket. Here we will have sine of a plus b, so x plus x 2x, then middle sign minus sine of a minus b, that is x minus x, that is 0. So guys, here I have applied the defactorization formula. Now there is one more way to solve this. Here you can multiply by 2 and divide by 2. So 1 by 2 will come here, and if you multiply by 2, that will become 2 sin x into cos x, which is nothing but sin 2x. So by both ways you get the same answer. Now value of sin 0 is 0, so it will be neglected. Then we will get y equal to half will come here, e to the power ax, and now we have cos x into sin of 2x. Now guys, again I will apply the formula of defactorization for cos x into sin 2x. So here we are gonna get half e to the power ax as it is. Now this will give us half in bracket sin of a plus b, that will become 3x, minus sin of a minus b, that is x minus 2x, that is negative x. Now guys, we all know that sin of minus theta is minus sin theta, so minus sin will come outside, that will become positive. So here we will get 1 by 4, because half into half is 1 by 4, e to the power ax, and in the bracket sin of 3x plus sin of x, and this is the value of y. Now guys, I can take this e to the power ax in the bracket, it will multiply sin 3x and sin x, and then we get the given function in the form of the formula. And guys, then I can apply the standard formula to get the nth derivative. So let's see what we get. So here I'll say y is equal to 1 by 4 in bracket e to the power ax into sine 3x plus e to the power ax into sine x. Now guys, here let's apply the formula for this e to the power ax into sine 3x. So by applying the formula, we will get nth derivative as 1 by 4 will remain as it is. Here we will get r raised to n. So here I'll say r1 raised to n, because again here I'm gonna get one more r, so I'll call that as r2. So r1 raised to n e to the power ax into sine of 3x plus n phi 1. Similarly, for the second function, we will get r2 raised to n e to the power ax into sine of x plus n phi 2. Now guys, let's write down the values of r1, r2, phi 1 and phi 2. So normally r is under root a square plus b square. So here value of a is a and b is 3. So here I'll say where r1 is equal to under root a square plus 9, because 3 square is 9, and r2 is equal to under root a square plus 1, because here guys the value of b is 1. Now value of phi 1 is tan inverse of b by a. So b is 3, a is a. So here I'll get tan inverse of 3 upon a. Similarly here I'll get phi 2 as tan inverse of 1 upon a. So guys, here we got the nth derivative of that given function, and we have applied that standard formula to get the answer. So this is the nth derivative of given function. So I'm sure you understood the method, how I explained you. So guys, if you get similar type of question in the exam, just solve it by the same method. And don't forget to share this channel with your friends, because friend in need is friend indeed. I am taking so much efforts for you all so that you can get good marks in engineering mathematics. So what I want is you should share this channel with your friends, tell them to subscribe so that they can also get benefited through these wonderful lectures of engineering mathematics. Thank you very much guys. Keep watching.